Rev up your engine!
Musk said that they're going to have a pickup truck hopefully in the summer. He calls it a cyberpunk truck. I mean, if anybody's going to make an electric pickup truck, he's got everything set up. All he's got to do is change the design and the frame and stuff like that. And I mean, Ford's got that deal going with the company in Michigan that they put a bunch of money in, and Amazon put a bunch of money in it too. They're going to have a full electric pickup up. So, you know, the race is on. We'll see who can make one that lasts the longest, that can hold up, and that doesn't cost a small fortune. The problem with Musk's stuff is his stuff is always super expensive, and what you actually pay for him versus the list price is often a line of baloney. Like when he said, oh, he's going to make the Model 3 at 30-something thousand, then they were all closer to $50,000. Volvo's coming out with an electric car, but all the ones that they're selling the first year are going to be like $15,000 more than that list price. A lot of it's just bait and switch with that stuff. So, you know, you never know. But if anybody can make a electric pickup truck, the guy makes electric cars, you know, we'll see what happens. I just wonder about the price point myself and how far these things can actually go, how much they actually weigh, because, of course, those batteries are heavy and pickup trucks have to be high by their very nature. And if it's really heavy and really high, they have a tendency of flipping over, where the other Tesla cars, the electric cars, are very low to the ground, and the batteries are low to the ground, so they corner really well. You don't have to worry about them tipping over because they're heavy, but they're low to the ground. Where a pickup truck's higher, I'd be interested in see what comes out of it. Hey, oh, says Scotty, what you thought on buying a 2008 4Runner with 78,000 miles that just had the engine head gasket replaced? I personally would not buy one that you knew the engine was worked on, because these days, a lot of guys don't know what the heck they're doing working on engines. I'll give you a perfect example. I had a customer that did the same thing. They had one. They bought, and the guy said the head gasket was replaced. A year later, the engine went out. Cams locked up. The engine had a hole in it from everything smashing together when he was going 70 miles an hour. The guy didn't rebuild it right when he did. And I see a lot of guys don't know what the heck they're doing anymore in engine work. It's very complicated. Costs a lot of money to buy the right parts. So personally, I wouldn't buy it because the engine's been taken apart. Who knows if it was done right or not? I mean, if you can get it really cheap and you want to gamble, what the heck? But if it's expensive, I wouldn't mess with it. James L52, and he says, Pontiac G6. I noticed it started to overheat. I turned the heat on and went back, but when I parked at the office, there was cooling all over the place. What should I do? Get jugs of water, pour water in. Leave the heater on. Start it up, and if the water isn't gushing like mad, turn the AC on full blast. That'll run the fans. And if you don't live that far, watch the temperature gauge. It doesn't overheat, drive it home. Then you can find out what's wrong there. So many reasons they can overheat. I've got a video, how to fix an overheating car engine. Watch it. It shows you absolutely anything can go wrong, how to check it all. But if you want to try to make it home and it's not that far and you fill it up, what the heck? Watch that temperature gauge and leave the radiator cap loose, like I said, so it doesn't build up the pressure and leak out faster, and have the AC on so the fans are blowing full blast. Now, if it did get hot on the way home, of course, turn it off before it got hot. And if push comes to shove, you make it most of the way it starts to get hot, shut it off, wait till it cools up, have some extra jugs of water, get a whole bunch of them, pour that bang in and go home the rest of the way. I've done that with lots of cars. Lala Throne One says, my check engine light comes on, but the car runs fine. Low flow EVAP system. What does that mean? Well, your EVAP system is an anti-pollution system, so gas vapors from your gasoline tank don't pollute the atmosphere. When I was a young mechanic, they didn't have any of that crap. They had a gas cap, and when it got hot, and if the gas expanded inside the tank, it would just vent a little bit of vapors outside. Well, that pollutes the world, according to the politicians that be. Even though we have cars that put out tons and tons and tons of carbon dioxide and all kinds of other stuff, they're worried about this tiny little bit of hydrocarbons coming out. So now they have systems that seal them in. When you're driving, if it does have vapor, it'll either reburn it through the car when you're driving it, or it'll go through the EVAP system into the charcoal canister, which is charcoal, filters out the hydrocarbons, and then out of the vent comes just clean air. Your system has low flow. That means for some reason that system's plugged up somewhere. A lot of times it's a plugged up EVAP canister, the charcoal canister. You can check that. This is an anti-pollution system. 99 times out of 100, your car will run perfectly fine. I've had people tell me that live in states where they don't do any of the emissions testing and check engines. They saw that's what's wrong with the car. They never never fixed it. They drove it 10 years that way. It ran perfectly fine. But if you live in a state where there's emissions, you got to figure out what's wrong. But you've got a problem that it's got low flow. So it's not the gas cap. So don't waste your money buying a gas cap. You got another problem. It could be a bad vent valve, charcoal canister, or something clogged up inside. Or like the video I just made, it could be a spider made a nest inside there. Because believe it or not, there are actually spiders that are attracted to the smell of gasoline. Their sensors pick up on it. And then they can make nests and block up the holes. I've seen that myself. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.